What's up, you guys? It's Turk and I'm back with another video, and today we are going to talk about Judas and the Black Messiah. Now, I know most of you watched that movie already on HBO Max, or you went to theaters and seen this movie, and you kind of got the gist of a Black Panther Party leader and a traitor. Well, I'm just here not to review the movie, but to tell you guys there was more to it to pick up on than rather just a messiah versus a traitor. Judas and the Black Messiah wasn't only a Fred Hampton movie, but it was William O'Neill's movie just as much. Soon as the movie starts, they show William first and have him do his dirt. And then that's when they sit him down, then give us the plot of the movie immediately. If this was just specifically a Fred Hampton movie, I think they would start off when he was younger, like a child, his upbringing, what motivated him to be a messiah or a leader of the Black Panther Party, the chairman of the Black Panther Party of Chicago, Illinois. So at this meeting, the FBI agents is already saying, we must stop the rise of any Black Messiah. A Black Messiah is a leader or savior of a particular group or cause, that in this case being Fred Hampton. Not too far into the movie, we see William O'Neill act like an FBI agent. He goes to the Crown's territory to a bar and he sticks them up. He was a car thief. So he would pat you down, take your keys, who has the red car outside, and he would take it and go. But this time he got caught. Now the actual FBI is questioning him, and he realized that William O'Neill is indeed robbing other Black people, which was not a big thing back then. It happened, of course, but this felt different. So he went to ask more questions. So we ask William O'Neill, hey, was you upset when Dr. King died? William says a little bit. The FBI agent goes, how about Malcolm X? Mr. O'Neill replies, I guess I never thought about it. At this point, the FBI agent sees that William O'Neill isn't one of the proud Black people. He's not like Black Power. He just happens to be Black and he's existing. So he thought, I have an offer for you. He could face the charges of robbery, impersonating an FBI agent, and other things, or he can work as an informant to bring down the Black Panther Party of Chicago, specifically assigned to Fred Hampton in this case, because, again, Fred Hampton is the rising Black Messiah of Chicago. A little later in the movie, they're having a meeting. William is telling the FBI agent, who is Roy Mitchell at this time, he's starting to be inspired by Fred Hampton. The FBI immediately tells William that the Black Panther Party are terrorists and bad people and do not fall for the tactics of manipulation. Little did William know that he was being manipulated by Roy Mitchell, the FBI agent. So again, this is not a movie review, it's just giving you guys the bigger message. And if you made it this far, here's the bigger message. I didn't just get a story of a traitor versus a leader shot twice in the head while he slept. Instead, I seen Mr. Hampton and the Black Panther Party were feeding the kids in the city for free. Thousands of kids every morning at that. Try giving them free health care. He wanted to open a clinic. Free education. They had their own food, their own buildings, construction workers, a community of Black-owned things where they kept the money cycling within each other, so it's possible to live and succeed just by supporting one another, not relying on any outside source, which seems pretty impossible today. Now, before white people are offended and feels excluded, he also united the Black Panther Party with the Young Patriots organization. That was a group of white people struggling in similar ways in Chicago. They were still getting beat by the police. Well, maybe not beat by the police, but you know, beat for their pockets, taxes, things like that. People taking extra money, you know how they come to the bar, the bookies, things like that. If you was a poor white person, you was almost treated as if you were black because they looked at you as filth and you was beneath them. Hispanic people of the group Young Lords also stood behind him for similar reasons. These are some of the things that I seen. There's a bigger picture, and yes, it's making you aware that there was a traitor, but it shouldn't be about the traitor. It should be about how they make communities work, how the government today makes it seem like it's impossible to do so. It was very, very possible back then. It could be a thing now if everybody put their minds together and made things work. Like, I'm from Boston. If you're familiar with Boston, Dorchester could be its own community and help each other out. Same thing with Mattapan, Roxbury, but everybody got to be willing. It's going to take everybody, just like he united everybody, all the gangs, the streets, the sets, things like that. Because there's a bigger picture. We're all getting cheated by the government. I know people think tax is not fair. The rich is staying rich because things are not fair. So if we is to take things in our hands and put our minds together, we could have communities that will protect each other and our pockets, physically and financially. That's all I really have for this. If you enjoyed, just leave a comment. I'm gonna write a few statuses on my Facebook if you want that. It's public, so you could join the conversation. And today is February 21st, which is the death anniversary of Malcolm X. And I have a video for that as well. So, thank you guys. I know it's been a little while. I've been very busy. I just came back from vacation. No, I didn't record anything. This was very private. And, yeah. See you guys real soon. Thank you.
On the deuce, I just wanted to get big on YouTube.
You're still here. Well, while you're here, go ahead and click that like button and the subscribe button. Okay, the notification bell too. Leave a comment saying you did so. Lastly, click the video on the right for more cool content. It's Turk time.